Researchers in Australia have created flexible material with nanoscale glass structures that can manipulate light, a potential precursor to smart contact lenses that display information. And RetroSense Therapeutics will inject viruses loaded with the DNA of light-sensitive algae into the eye of a legally blind person in the hopes of restoring their sight in black and white. Vsauce, Kevin here. This is Mind Blow. This may be the most human-like robot hand ever made. Researchers from the University of Washington created the anthropomorphic robot hand by laser scanning the bones of a human hand and 3D printing artificial replicas, and finally connecting them with artificial finger joints. It's controlled by 10 servos that act as muscles with cable that replicates the carpal tunnel, and the hope is that someday this system could be used as a scaffold for the growth of grafted cells to regenerate human hands. Tiny quartz discs could store data for billions of years. First detailed in 2011, it stores data via laser-etched nanostructures, which can be read by passing light through the crystal and having an automated microscope algorithm translate the light changes. The UK researchers now have a working prototype, and the next step is to speed up the write time as well as the read time of the discs that can store 360 terabytes, can withstand temperatures up to 1,000 degrees, and have a room temperature lifespan of 13.8 billion years. To free up traffic, Switzerland is considering a special tunnel for automated delivery trucks. A three-lane tunnel located 50 meters underground would allow passage for the electric delivery vehicles. The idea is to completely eliminate big trucks in urban areas and replace them with much smaller trucks that do the basic point A to point B delivery. But first, some private financing needs to foot the $3.4 billion bill, and if that does happen, the earliest it would open is 2030. Here's an artist's rendering of the first successfully analyzed atmosphere of a super-Earth. A super-Earth is a planet outside of our solar system with a mass higher than Earth's but much lower than gas giants like Neptune. Researchers from the University College London recently analyzed 55 Cancri E's atmosphere and discovered it consists mainly of helium and hydrogen. And due to orbiting so close to its sun, it's at least 2,000 degrees there. Tectonic Technologies is developing pressure-sensing mats for virtual reality. They use hundreds of small force plates with measured data sent to a computer that translates real-time reactions in the game. They've used it to simulate flying, bending, shifting weight, and stepping, and they hope to start selling these by the end of 2016. Scientists from the National Institute of Polar Research revived Antarctic tardigrades frozen for over 30 years. Taken from frozen moss in 1983 and stored at minus 20 degrees, the samples were recently defrosted. The tardigrades essentially woke up from suspended animation, ate some algae, and went on to successfully reproduce. So, yeah. In the spirit of using robots to augment human ability, researchers at Georgia Tech created a three-armed drummer. The smart arm responds not only to gestures, but also the music it hears. So, for example, if the drummer moves to play the hi-hat, the smart arm adjusts to play the ride cymbal. The drummer scenario is used as a proof of concept because it's reliant upon precise timed movements, but this idea could be eventually implemented on doctors, mechanics, or technicians who could use an extra hand. The next steps are to link the movements directly to the user's brain. I featured a soft, wearable robotic glove in MindBlow 96 developed at Harvard, but this new exoglove from Seoul National University is more compact and more comfortable. The flexible, waterproof, polymer soft robot is tendon-driven using actuators and allows grasping of various objects for people with hand disabilities. Finally, Hydromorph is a water-shaping device for display and interaction. Potential applications include the water purposefully avoiding your hands if the temperature is too hot, or showing you different shapes to indicate the weather or if the water is safe to drink. Honestly, I'm showing you this just because I think it looks cool. I'm gonna leave you with a full-scale spaceship drop test, and as always, thanks for watching.
Of living and new thinking have laid the foundation for most of what is good in life today, with the promise of more tomorrow. as distant families have become neighbors, and as people have constantly widened their viewpoints while multiplying the number of their contacts, more desires have developed to be satisfied.